Caesar!
Caesar!
Hail Maurice. Caesar! There's Maurice. Maurice! And folks call me Maurice. Wink, wink. I showed you the world.
But now you're here.
It's amazing.
To finish us off. For good.
Epic.
Yeah, I know.
Right? Epic.
Hey, Hamish, what's up? Getting crazy.
Would hear us trying to be all intimidating.
If he's a bald, that means he needs business.
Yeah.
All the toughest people in the world are bald. Daytona, Aim, Bruce Willis and Die Hard. Killen, even though he's not as strong as, you know, as Vegeta, but you get the picture.
It will be a planet of apes.
I see what they did then. Sweet. Can't wait. That's what happens when you don't pay the bartender, I guess.
All of human history has led to this moment. The irony is we created you. And nature has been punishing us.
Caesar on a horse. Yeah, that's pretty epic. That's my new aesthetic. Not gonna lie, I'm tempted to switch sides, honestly. I mean, have you seen how things are right now, Thur? I mean, like, maybe the apes could do a better job.
To get the record straight, I'm definitely switching sides. Okay, everybody. So, you're watching another episode of FunSmithsInternational, and this time we're actually appearing on camera. Yeah, you weren't missing much. And today I actually have my brother with me, because I did say before that it would always just be me. So, do you have anything you want to say for starters?
Hello, interwebs. This is my friend Steve, and he's an orangutan, and I think I can trust him so far. He hasn't done anything to a... to put me 6 feet under yet. He seems pretty sweet. Hi! I'm Steve! I got long arms.
And this is George.
George. Yeah, Curious George. Yeah, we got lazy, I guess.
Because, of course, today we are going to be talking about the new War for the Planet of the Apes. Wow, the lighting is so bad in here.
It really is.
It's really bad. Like I could barely see you. See, but hey, that's at least better than not being able to see us at all.
In case you're wondering, really. We're actually in our basement, in our old junk room.
Gosh, this is full of crap.
We're actually gonna be moving this fall in like October. or something.
Look at all this crap. Okay, we're getting way off topic. Okay, so you know, actually, I'll start. Here, why don't I make it easier? Let me give you the camera. You film me talking, and I'll have George here.
Radio, governor.
So anyways, the new movie, War for the Planet of the Apes, is coming out. For those of you that are not familiar with this franchise, well, it basically goes back to 1968. The very first Planet of the Apes film that came out stars Charlton Heston, a very famous actor who you may also know from movies like Ben-Hur, The Ten Commandments, and that one movie where everybody was eating people. What's that one called again?
Silent Green.
Oh, yeah. There's also that one where he was swimming, people swimming pools. I forget what that one was going to do.
Mm-hmm. For the record, I think you accidentally called him Charlie Hester. It's Charlton Heston.
Okay. Okay.
We apologize.
Sorry, Charlton Heston's descendants. But in that movie, that movie's a classic. It's a great movie. So in that movie, of course, it presents this universe where apes rule on this one planet. Charlton Heston is a time traveler from the past, comes into the future, ends up on this planet. He ends up actually working with both the chimps and the humans against the gorillas who go by, and you see this long struggle between the apes and the humans. They don't get along because, of course, the apes are risen up and they're the dominant species now, but they put the differences aside because they gotta stop the gorillas who have gotten out of control. And the big twist in the movie, though, at the very end, is Charlton Heston realizes that this isn't just any old planet. This is our planet. This is Earth. He finds the Statue of Liberty in ruins. And you know what? I'm going to let you say, because you seem to really love saying the line. And then he says, "You blew it up! You blew it up! Damn you all to hell! You damn dirty apes!"
I'm not sure if I got the quote exactly right, but I just love that moment.
But there is one specific thing in that movie that stood out besides that, which was they talk about the first ape tries up was an ape named Caesar. So years in the future, in 2001, Tim Burton made a really crappy-ass remake of it that was a complete flop. That was hated by critics and audiences, just both. But we're not going to, that's enough of that. We're not going to talk anymore about that, though. But then years later, though, 2023 Fox came up with the idea, instead of trying to remake it, let's just kind of reimagine it, but still make it connected. So they came out with a series of prequels, started with Rise of the Planet of the Apes in 2011. These movies would basically explain kind of how the planet came to be. And those movies center on the main character. Yep, you guessed it. Caesar the Ape.
Hell, Caesar!
Caesar the Ape is one of the greatest characters I've seen in a movie in recent years, at least. Like, he's one of the best characters, protagonists in movies right now. But anyways, so in
Rise of the Planet, he has better luck than the Roman Caesar, I'll tell you that. He hasn't managed to get stabbed yet.
So, in Rise of the Planet,
not yet, at least.
We see where they're trying to, by the way, this is very spoiler heavy, as you've already realized that.
Spoiler alert. For anyone who hasn't seen the movie, it's been like 6 years now, get on it.
You really do, because it's great. Okay, so they're trying to find the cure for Alzheimer's. James Franco plays the main doctor. His dad is played by Jonathan Gallen in the movie. His dad has Alzheimer's. And they do some tests on some chips. And one of those chips, of course, is Caesar. Oh, no, actually, it's his mom, sorry. Sorry, and then he's born, and then he of course gets off her genes, and he becomes really smart. And James Franco takes him home to raise him. He gives his dad some of the same medicine. And his dad gets Alzheimer's. And Caesar keeps getting more and more smart. And, of course, Caesar gets a little wild on Coachella. And then he ends up having to be taken to an animal shelter by animal control. James Franco tries to fight it and get him out. And then he eventually escapes from that animal shelter, lets a bunch of the other apes loose, gives them the medicine, breaks into zoos, gives other apes medicine, breaks into, like, the science lab where they're doing stuff, gives those apes the medicine and stuff, and then they all become really smart, and eventually he gets to where he speaks, and the movie kind of ends with him and the monkeys going off into the wild, and of course he has one final goodbye with James Franco, but he says that these are my people, so I'm gonna leave these people. He kind of says that, not in those words exactly, but then though there's a horrible catastrophe that hits, which is, well, there's a negative effect to the chemical that they test on the apes. The apes are immune to it, but the humans are not. So the humans, they all get this deadly disease, and a good chunk of them end up dying out. And then that brings us into the second film in this current prequel series, which is Dawn of the Planet of the Apes, where we see Caesar, once again, played by Andy Serkis. I don't think I mentioned that before, but yeah, he's played by Andy Serkis. He's the motion capture king. He's great in the role.
We want it.
Yes, he's going for those in the Lord of the Rings, for those of you that don't know.
That was a horrible imitation, I just did. I apologize. I apologize to the great Andy Serkis.
Yeah, you really should apologize for that.
And just to let you know, can you move your head so much? I'm having a hard time following you just a little bit.
Okay, sorry. Is this better?
Yes, that's good. That is good.
Is this better?
Yeah, it's good. It's good, don't worry. You're fine.
He becomes a lot smarter. He's talking a lot more. A lot of the apes are talking more. They think all the humans have died out. The year is now 2024. But then they discover there's some humans that are still alive. Those humans show up looking for help. They're trying to make contact to see if there are any other survivors so that they can start with the human race. Caesar helps them because Caesar, of course, he's a good guy. He wants to help them. Then one of the other apes, it's like one of his most trusted advisors, Copa, he's not liking what Caesar's doing. He doesn't trust the humans at all, so he goes apeshit, literally. kills a bunch of the humans, then shoots Caesar and tries to frame the humans for it, because he is just so determined to get rid of the humans. He no longer cares about who he harms in the plot. He doesn't care about Caesar anymore. He's like, no, because Caesar loves the humans more than he does. Like, he was.
Oh, I think you're just being kind of harsh to Cope. I mean, he's just trying to make the planet great again.
Yeah, went there. Sorry.
Sorry. Can't resist.
And that, of course, brings us to Gary Oldman's character in the movie, who, when all the apes go apeshit, start attacking them, and Caesar's injured. Eventually, Caesar, gets some help, and he tries to get back on his feet. He tries to stop Cobra. Gary Oldman tries to blow up their tower. Many of the apes escape, some do not, and like, one of the main human that's working with Caesar, who befriends Caesar, is in there too. So you see that he's just like Copa, and you see, it's like, you can't tell the humans and apes apart anymore, because they're both become so savage. Especially the animal character that I forget, and Copa, played by, Toby Kebbell, who's got in the movie. So Copa eventually gets killed by Caesar. Caesar throws him off a large building, and that's it for Copa, or is right now, as we think, you never know. And then
might come back, it might pull like a Shyamalan twist and say, yeah, here he is, what a twist.
Then the main human tells Caesar that Gary Oldman has already caught up. A bunch of humans from up north. He's caught up with the colonel. They're already coming.
Colonel Sanders.
Get on with the video. And that brings us into this next movie, which we'll pick up right where that one left off, because that's kind of how that one ends. And we meet our new main bad guy, the Colonel, played by Woody Harrelson. Okay, so from what we've seen in the trailer, well, of course, these films have tons of homages and throwbacks to the original film, especially the very first one. And one, of course, is we see the ape riding on horseback into the sunset. That's a famous scene from the very first one with Tarzan Heston. We see a barista orangutan who is Caesar's best friend, and he's pretty much his best friend from, like, going back to the very first one. And he's just right here, man. Used to kind of be him a cope of both. Of course, that now it's just mainly him. They find a young girl who's been abandoned, it looks like. So they kind of end up raising her. And from what I've heard, Caesar is kind of going through a battle with himself, though, because even Caesar, based on something in the circus recently, based on something that happened kind of at the very beginning, it just kind of sets Caesar off the wall. He's almost like, no more Mr. Nice Abe. And he's about ready to just go AWOL himself on other humans. Now, I'm sure by the end of the movie, he'll be more reasonable. He'll go back to be kind of the mediator. Like, when the humans and the ape have to try to get along. But, you know, if you've seen the original films or you're aware of the original films, I just mentioned them, we kind of know how it ends. The apes ultimately do win the war. They continue to run the plan, but there'll probably be plenty of humans that survive. Those are some of the more basic predictions that you can make from what you've seen. But also, we see where one ape is being, I don't know if he's being paid off by one of the humans. You see him in one of the trailers. But he's working with them. As he just said, I don't know what they promised you, what they told you, but you'll never be one of them. You're an ape. And Woody Harrelson and Andy Serkis, their interactions together in the film look really good. The chemistry is really good because you just really see the tension that they've created. They probably both deserve Oscar nomination for this film. I haven't even said it yet, but I'll say that. But Andy Serkis already deserved it for the last one. I think even Toby Kebbell both gave great performances the last one. They both deserved it. I don't know why they don't just give Andy Serkis an Oscar. Not already, but that's a topic for another day. And here, there's some predictions you want to make. How about you try to make some predictions of what you think is going to happen in the film?
Well, I don't know if anyone ever saw Rogue One, the Star Wars story, watching this, but they do this cool thing with the, you know, Tarkin, General Tarkin, who was in A New Hope. They bring you some CGI and bring him in, and it's a really cool homage. I mean, you do kind of notice it, and it does kind of get a little creepy, you could say, but it's nice they go that extra mile. And I just wanted to say that I think it would be cool if they did some kind of something kind of like that with Charlton Heston. Even though he's been dead a long time now. Quite a good while. Like about
passed away in 2008, so
9 years. 9 whole years. And I think it would be cool if they had found a way to insert him, his likeness into it.
Yeah, and you know, you could have him go back in time to when the planet starts and have interact with Caesar briefly. That'd be really cool if they did that. I don't really think they're going to do it, though, and that's fine if they don't, but that would be cool, though. And I do wonder if we'll see James Franco's character again, possibly. He did have a cameo in the form of an old video that Caesar was watching in the last film.
I hope they play the band's music some more.
Oh, yeah, because they used The Way by the band in the last movie.
It was one of those moments that I like when they do things like that. They put in kind of these lighthearted moments to, in between, you know, when the chaos is going on, basically, like, kind of break up the chaos. I like that.
And we might see some of the other humans from the last film back. Caesar tells them that they better go because they don't want them stuck in the mill, but they might come back before we get to the very end of it. But, you know, that kind of brings us to, we kind of test upon it earlier, that brings us to kind of another big predictor thing we could talk about. But actually, we're gonna save that for the next video. So until then, thank you for watching. Please don't forget to comment, subscribe if you want to, like, or heck, dislike, I don't care.
You can subscribe to this crap if you actually like it. You can do that. We're more than welcome.
Nobody watches this show, so yeah, please watch it. Or no, I don't really care either. We just like doing it. And let us know what you think. Let us know if you give some of our statements, or you give some of our predictions if you're looking forward to the movie. And what was your favorite between the last Planet of the Apes movie? And if you disagree, feel free to disagree too. But until then, though, what is this doing? You know what? Why don't we talk to Maurice for a minute?
His name is Steve.
Well, it's Maurice in the movie, though, so.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, okay. We have him.
I named him Steve, though. We named him Steve. But yeah, Maurice! He's playing the role of Maurice.
So is this Caesar then?
Yeah, he's playing the role of Caesar. Hey, you want me to say anything else? You want him to give a shout out to something or something?
You can have him give a shout out to his character.
Okay, I'll shout out to Maurice then. Maurice.
He's an awesome character. I love him. He's a
great
character.
Me too. Some people call me Maurice. Wham, wham.
Together, U is for you and me, N is for anywhere and anytime at all,
down here in the deep blue sea. F is for fire that burns down the whole town, U's for uranium bombs, N is for no survivors when you're...
Plankton, those things aren't what fun is all about. Now, do it like this. F is for friends who do stuff.
Never. That's completely idiotic.
Here, let me help you. F is for friends who do stuff together. U is for you and me. Try it.
N is for anywhere at any time at all.
Down here in the deep blue sea.
Wait, I don't understand this. I feel all tingly inside. Should we stop?
No, that's how you're supposed to feel.
Well, I like it.